The DateTime data type in DAX is represented as a floating point value. The integer part represents the number of days after December the 30th, 1899. Therefore, 2 in DAX represents 2 days after December the 30th, that is, the 1st of January 1900. The decimal part of this floating point is the fraction of the day, and it represents the time part of the day time. So 1 second in DAX, in order to represent 1 second in DAX, you divide 1, that is 1 day, by 24 hours, 60 minutes, 60 seconds, and the tiny number is the representation of 1 second. You can trust this mathematical representation. So, for example, if you want to move a date forward in time, you simply add a value to it. Any date plus 1 goes to the next day. Any date minus 1 goes to the previous day. And if you need to compute the difference in days between 2 days, you can simply subtract 1 day from the other, and what you obtain is the number of days in between the 2 days. Let's see a couple of examples of these mathematical calculations. I create a variable sample date, which is a decimal. It contains 4.10. And then I represent it as a date. Now, 4.10 contains the integer part 4, that is 4 days after December the 30th. It turns to be the 3rd of January 1900. The fraction of the day is .10. .10 is 10% of 24 hours, that is 2.4 hours, still using the decimal representation. If we move it to time representation, is 2.24. Indeed, you see that sample date formatted as a string is the 3rd of January 1900 at 2.24 in the morning. If you add 1, that goes to the 4th of January, so the day after. And if you use trunc to remove the decimal part from sample date, what you obtain is only the date part with no time part.